Brand new to VideoStudio, you found the right place to get started. In the next 8 minutes, I'll take you through what you need to know to begin. We start with a blank project, so let's import some media into our library. First, we'll create a new folder by clicking Add. Give it a name, and then go to Browse, and drag and drop our media into the library. You can filter your library to see just, for example, video files by clicking the buttons to hide photos and audio files. When we start a new project, we can use a project template to speed things up. Just click on Instant Project, then drag the template you want to use to the timeline. To replace the placeholders, we just go back to our media library and click and drag a clip on top of the placeholder and hold down Control when releasing the drag. You can quickly create great-looking videos in this way with templates. And here's how it can start to look with our footage added. But let's say we don't want to use a template in this case. Let's go to File, New Project. To add media to our timeline, we will simply drag and drop. When you add a clip to the timeline, you will see a check mark added to the thumbnail. Please note, by default, the first clip you add to the timeline sets your project's properties and size. This is an option you can set and control under Settings. To play a clip on our timeline, we can press the play button located here, or just press the spacebar. Or you can scrub through your project and find a certain spot. And for this, we use the scrubber and drag it along the clip. We can zoom in and zoom out on the timeline by using the zoom icons to the right. Or click the Auto Fit button to snap all of the timeline into view at once. To trim the length of a video or template, you can move your mouse near the yellow boundary and drag inwards. Or we can move the scrubber along the timeline to the point we wish to cut, and then either press the Split Clip button or the shortcut S on our keyboard to split the clip into two parts. And then we can just delete the part that we don't want. To crop, resize or reposition the picture on your screen, first select the clip on the timeline, then go to Distort Tools here in the Preview panel, and we can then choose to scale or crop the clip as we want it to appear in our video. Let's add some more clips to the timeline. We can drag in another video and a photo as well. We can click here to open the Transitions library. Transitions are short animations that make the change from one clip to the next a bit more interesting, rather than just cutting from one clip to the next. To add a transition, just drag it to either end of a clip in the timeline or between two clips. And here's what that transition looks like with our footage. We can adjust the length of the transition by positioning the cursor along the edge of the transition indicator and then dragging. We can add the same transition between a series of clips on the main track. Just right-click on the transition and click Apply Current Effect to Video Track. This is great to quickly create a really nice-looking slideshow from a series of images. Double-click the transition to edit the transition parameters. In this case, we can add a border to the transition pieces, change the border color, and even change the direction of the transition. Just like transitions, we can drag and drop effects onto our clip to get a desired look. To preview effects and transitions added to a clip, position the scrubber and press play. We can double-click on a clip to control the effects that are added to this clip, customizing the effect like this. We can press this icon to turn the effects on and off so we can see our original footage, and remove effects or filters by selecting them in the list and then pressing the X to delete them. We can also edit the clip. For example, we can really quickly add a pan and zoom, which can help make photos look much more dynamic in your video. or we can correct the clip, for example, turning the brightness down a bit. When you're editing, sometimes you just need more space. To work across multiple screens, you can always detach a window by double-clicking on the dots at the top left of each window, and then move it to a separate screen, or just customize the windows to suit your own preference. To pop it back in, we double-click this icon again. To add titles, frames, or overlay videos, we can add them so they display above our main video. We do this by dragging clips onto the overlay or titles tracks on our timeline. To add a new track, right-click and select either Insert Track Above or Below. Let's drag a clip onto the overlay track. Adjust the length that the clip will display for. And we can even then animate the clip so that it slides in and out. To add a title, click the title icon, select a preset, and drag it to the timeline. And then double-click on the preview pane to enter the text. We can change the font, the text alignment, and a host of other options to customize how the text is displayed. We can also adjust the position and length of the clip in the usual way. When we add a video with audio to our timeline, the clip will have a speaker icon. And when we click Sound Mixer from the toolbar just above the timeline, we can see the audio waves attached to the video. We can make adjustments to the existing audio track by double-clicking the clip to open the editor. And we can adjust the volume of the whole clip and apply a fade-in and fade-out effect. By right-clicking on the clip, we can either mute the audio or split the audio to another track. VideoStudio comes with a royalty-free music library which you can use in your videos. To access it, we just click on the auto music icon, and we can preview the music. And then click to add it directly to the timeline, auto-trimmed to the length of our video. As you edit, don't forget to save as you go along. To save your project so you can open your working file to continue editing, select File, Save As. Once you're done with your video, just select the Share tab, and you can export to popular video formats. Upload online straight to your social channels from within VideoStudio, or burn the video straight to a disk. For more tutorials on features in VideoStudio, visit the Home tab inside VideoStudio or our YouTube channel at Corel VideoStudio.